Well, the pandemic year, as many may have termed it, has been quite a challenging one for businesses across sectors of the Nigerian economy, obviously, be it MSME, which have been mostly affected, or the industries which have since been crippled by drop in the income of its potential consumers, lockdowns, which meant having these shops under lock and key. But there's one business which, despite the challenges, have managed to weather the storm and keep its head above waters amidst the waves. ShopX TV is the first tele-shopping and multi-channel retail business based in Nigeria. The brand was officially launched in 2020 and has witnessed tremendous success in marketing and selling its products across the country. This Nigerian-owned company that has managed to successfully navigate its way through a difficult season and still growing ShopX TV retails innovative lifestyle, fitness, and kitchen products using television. The brand is the exclusive distributor of some of the world's most successful, as seen on TV products. One of its most popular products, the Copper Chef, an innovative non-stick pan that can be used to create a variety of healthy and wholesome meals. It also recently launched a Power Air Fryer, a healthier option to air frying, baking, grilling, steaming, and roasting food. Well, what more should Nigerians expect from this first of its kind, a Nigerian-based tele-shopping business? I have the right person in the house to discuss this. He's joining me live in our Lagos studio. He's the founder and chief executive officer of ShopX TV, Mr. Isi Abebe. Mr. Abebe, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
Sincerely, while reading the introduction, I was already feeling hungry. Roasting, healthy food, and all of the fresh things I was talking about. Well, that's on a lighter note. Tell us about this journey of ShopX TV. Tell us, how did it all start?
I mean, my background really is started off in the UK.
Okay.
I have a lot of experience deploying television channels. And one of the things that I was fortunate enough to have been engaged with was a business called High Street Television. And I was there for a couple of years, and they're one of the largest teleshopping companies in the UK. I think it was in that capacity I began to understand how teleshopping works, because it's quite a complicated dance of various operations. So you've got to identify the right products, you've got to bring them into the country, you've got to put together your warehouse, and then you also need your call center, and you need the technology behind it, and then you need your media spend and your media buy. So in the process of understanding the dance of how teleshopping works, I began to observe that that operation didn't exist in Nigeria or in West Africa. And I felt that there was really a need to introduce a lot of innovative products into the Nigerian market. And that's really how it really started off.
Sounds so interesting. I used to say something, Nigeria has that population, so any market is always a good way to tap into
Absolutely.
But a lot of buzz about ShopX TV every time, just now before even the program, you know, it's everywhere, you know. Tell us about some of your products and what you currently sell. Let's look at the Copper Chef products and the Power Air Fryer.
I mean, to be honest with you, these are great products, and I'm not saying it because I'm trying to sell them. I am. But they actually are products that really bring our market in line with the quality of products globally. So they're a lot healthier. For example, the Copper Chef pan is a lot healthier. It's non-stick. It's POFO-free, which means that it doesn't have all these chemicals that chip and peel when you're using them. And it's just a healthier option when you're looking to reduce your calories and your cholesterol levels. I don't know if you're aware, but Nigerians, for example, the mortality rate in Nigeria, average mortality rate is quite low, simply because we don't do enough exercise.
Yeah.
We go in and out of our cars. We have meals that are not particularly healthy, high in cholesterol, high in calories, deep palm oil kind of food, and we eat late. We don't exercise enough. So these products really address those issues, and hopefully we'll continue to introduce the healthier option for cooking meals.
That's a very good one. That healthy aspect is what's really catching me, and I know a lot of Nigerians. Now, you touch on teleshopping itself in its entirety. This is like in Nigeria for the first time.
It is.
Now, how does it work practically?
I mean, in a nutshell, you see a commercial on television, as a lot of your viewers have been on TVC, and they call the telephone number, and our call center takes the order, and if you live in Lagos, it's delivered to your house in 2 to 3 working days. That's really it, to be honest. You have various other options of placing an order for the product. So you can go to our website, www.shopxtv.com. We also have an active interaction with our audiences on Instagram.
Good.
So when you DM, we can also process your orders there. So it's an omni-retailer that advertises its products on television, the traditional broadcast platform, as well as digital, online, and our websites.
So you're everywhere. How receptive are Nigerians to all of these products?
Interestingly, when I first introduced the idea, because initially I came to Nigeria and I had to raise the money to start the business.
Can imagine.
And because it's not a model that exists in the country, nobody had a clue, what I was talking about. So the idea that you could market this product on television and people will pick up their phones and order, didn't really feel, wasn't really an attractive enough proposition. And I was a bit skeptical as well
about it.
But the response has been very, very positive. Obviously, it's driven by a very aggressive television campaign. And I think gradually, once you build a brand and it has the right brand values and reputation, integrity, excellent customer services, reliability, delivering on your promises, it really then began to catch on. And then people began to see ShopX TV as a brand that they can recognize, as opposed to the on and off businesses that sometimes happen, especially in the digital platform. And so that's what we do. We want to build a brand that people can trust and they will continue to order from us.
Indeed. Now let's now go to 2020. That was part of my introduction. Wasn't exactly the best year. Everyone would talk about COVID what happened. Yeah. So how did this impact your business one way or the other?
You know, I feel particularly blessed because I've had conversations with other entrepreneurs who have had to make very, very tough decisions and tough cuts in their staff, in their operations. I think fortunately for us, by the grace of God, fortunately for us, what we were able to do before the crisis was to build a robust infrastructure to support ourselves, support all our operations. We developed an end-to-end digital transaction in terms of the way we process payments and deliver our goods to our customers. So by the time COVID came, we were able to move quite quickly. One of the things which we had to do quite quickly was to migrate our entire call center operations from a physical location to a cloud-based solution. So all our agents were working from home. That was quite tough, and we had about 48 hours to do that, which we successfully did. Now, by adequately preparing the business and the staff to ensure business continuity, we were able to then benefit from what turned out to be an increase in TV viewing audiences, because obviously when people are locked down, there are more people at home watching television. So we actually saw our sales increase and perform better during the COVID. Mm. And that's something that we are grateful to God for.
That's really a good one. Let's now see, do you see yourself becoming, another Jumia or Konga, you know? Is that?
You know, I get asked this question often. I mean, Jumia and Konga are online aggregators, so they're platforms that enable merchants to sell their products. We don't really see ourselves as containing a wide portfolio of products. I mean, we're not going to be selling everything, like shoes and clothes and, you know, everything that you can currently get on Jumia or Konga.
Okay.
What we do is we specialize on niche products, products with strong brand values, quality products with great appeal in terms of being able to demonstrate the features and the benefits on television. And we secure exclusive licenses to distribute these products across Nigeria, and we maintain that exclusivity. So I think what would happen is would only be a fraction in terms of the product portfolio of the number of products that we sell compared to the larger e-commerce retailers.
That also sounds...
But by the way, we also have a presence on Jumia and Konga. So we sell our products.
Okay, there. You sell absolutely via the platforms too?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. So now what more are we expecting? You know, Nigerians would always want more. What more would they expect from me? I was thinking of even before that, I wanted to ask you any form of challenges, because businesses in Nigeria, they all have challenges.
Yes,
Forex issues? Is that all of this and all of that? What challenges? Yes. Let's talk about that before we go to what we should expect.
Well, I think we have a big counterfeit problem. I think a good example is Copper Chef. Before we introduced Copper Chef into the Nigerian market, nobody was selling Copper Chef. But as a result of the drive and the TV campaigns and commercials, suddenly we have a lot of pop-up stores online and in market selling fake Copper Chef products. And the challenge with these fake products is that they're actually quite dangerous, because when you begin to use them after a while, the fake copper lining of the pan starts peeling off into your food, and then people are now using this to eat. So we're constantly trying to
deal with these issues with our legal team. I think that's a big issue for us, just counterfeit products in the market.
That's the major one you face.
I think that's the major one.
Well,
airtime is quite expensive as well.
Yeah. You know, television actually is not cheap. You know?
It's not cheap.
But let's now look at what products, what more products are we expecting? Because, you know, this innovation and, you know, technology driven and all of that. Tell us what more we should expect and what you want Nigerians to know.
Well, in the next couple of weeks, we're going to launch relaunch it. We launched it last year. It did really well, sold out. So we're bringing it back into the market, which is like a stretch denim jeans for one size fits all for women. We're also going to launch a Contour Pillow brand, which is a great bed collection for people with heart issues, sleeping, or difficulties in back pain, and also for pregnant women. And then finally, we'll be launching a great item called the Genie Bra. That should be quite interesting and something we'll be looking forward to launch quite soon.
So Nigerians should expect all of these goodies as we move on. How is the market like in its entirety? That's market space. How are you playing in that market?
I think that there's, a lot of it depends on the economy as well.
True. You know, true.
What we anticipate is that with an increase in middle class, we're hoping to see a lot more people with disposable income being able to afford these products.
Yeah.
And people who have the luxury of buying products that are, you know, beneficial for their health and so forth. But generally, I think it's been a very good response. And I think there's a demand for it. And as much as we can, we're going to ensure that we are taking the market leadership position in this space, and we'll continue to do so for a while.
Oh, well, it's good to leave it at that now. Chief Executive Officer and founder of Shopex TV had been speaking to Mr. Isi Abebe, breaking it down, letting us understand what all of this means. I think I need to also get my own power air fryer so I can also,
I'll hook you up.
Thank you so much for your time. I appreciate you on the show.
So
it's really good to
Thank
have you.
Thank you so much.
Oh,